Hello friend, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss some expected questions on Indian economy, and this is the part 2. If you like, share and subscribe. Let's move to the first question. In terms of economy, the visit by foreign nationals to witness the Commonwealth Games in India amounted to. That means the question is being asked it, if a foreigners visit our country, then what kind of investment will it would be? Whether it would be export, whether it would be import, production or consumption. So whenever a foreign national visit our country, they actually come here and purchase and they pay dollar or converted rupees into us. That means it is a kind of export. So the right answer is export. Whenever a national visit India, it is actually a kind of export. Next question, which one of the following statement appropriately describe the fiscal stimulus? Fiscal stimulus, first of all, understand what is fiscal stimulus. Whenever economy of a country goes sluggish, that means slow down or some kind of recession or depression is faced by economy. So according to John Maynard Keynes, or it is also called Keynesian economy, according to that view, if government have to spend money for encouraging growth in the market, so the fiscal stimulus means actually if you can read all the statement, right answer is it is an intense affirmative action, that is the government spend money to boost economic activity in the country, and this economic activity led to the consumption and spending money in the market. It is a fiscal stimulus. It is announced by government of India. Normally all the government announce fiscal stimulus, and another is called monetary stimulus. What is monetary stimulus? Monetary stimulus is announced by RBI. It is a kind of they increase the money supply in the market, and if the money supply is increased in the market, people will have more money in their hand and they will purchase, and it will lead to economic growth. To obtain the full benefits of demographic dividend, what should India do? Demographic dividend, first of all we should understand what is demographic dividend. It is a kind of situation or a condition in economy because of birth rate. Whenever adult population of a country are younger, then they can produce more, or they can be used in more in the production. If we have more youth in our country, then how we should use them? We should use them promoting skill development, introducing more social security scheme, reducing infant mortality rate, privatization of higher education. Actually, to gain the benefit of demographic dividend, we will have to promote skill development. If our youth have more skill, they can help in the production of an economy, and this will lead to the growth of the country. Next question, it is also related to demographic tradition, a transition and with economic development. We know that if we have demographic transition, demographic dividend, then it led to economic development. But here is a statement 1, 2 and 3, low birth rate with low death rate, high birth rate with high death rate. So what should be the correct chronology? So the right answer is 2, 3, 1. Why? First of all, if you will see, this is the first stage of demographic transition. High birth rate and high death rate too. After that, you will find high birth rate, but death rate will slow down due to economic development and other technological advancement in medical world. After that, this is the number 1, this is the number 2, and after the number 3rd is low birth rate, and at the same time death rate will also decrease. So demographic transition is 2, 3, 1. This is the 2, 3, 1. What does venture capital means? First of all, capital means a kind of monetary investment in something. And here the question is venture capital. So there are different type of capital investment, and but venture capital, it is a kind of investment where it is a long term and it is invested in a startup capital. A startup, it is like suppose there is a firm, a small business outlet, and they are just they have ideas but they do not have money. So big entrepreneurs or big big firms, they invest in such startup companies and they get equity share or large amount of return in this. So venture capital, like Amazon, like Amazon has been investing, or Tata have been investing in some small startup. These are known as venture capital. Sometimes it is also known as angel capital also, like Farista. They work as a Farista. Next question: with reference to union budget, which of the following is covered under the non-plan expenditure? This is a type of classification of planning, and it is a plan expenditure and non-plan expenditure. Those which were covered by the five-year plan were called plan expenditure, and those did not come under the planning commission, that was known as the non-plan expenditure. So here, defense expenditure is also a non-plan expenditure. Interest payment, it is also a non-plan expenditure. Salaries and pensions are also non-plan expenditure, and at the same time subsidies are also non-plan expenditure. So our right answer is 3, 1, 2, and 3. Next question: if the interest rate is decreased in an economy, it will. So suppose there is a 10% interest rate, and suppose we purchase something, we take a loan from bank, so we will have to pay 10% interest rate. But after some time, it is found that bank has decreased the interest rate. So let's say it come down to 6%. What will happen? I will take more loan, or people will take more loan from the bank. And in that process, what will happen? Decrease the consumption expenditure? No, it will never, because if we will have more money, we will spend more money in the economy. So the statement one is wrong. Increase in the tax collection of the government, to some extent it is true, but let's see what are other option. Increase in the investment expenditure in the economy, of course. If we will have more money, a company have more money, they will obviously, they will spend that money, they will take more loan from the bank, and they will invest in their respective firms. Totals, increase in the total saving? No. When we will go for saving? When the interest rate are higher. But here the question is asked that interest rate has been decreased, so we will not go for saving, we will go for expenditure, and so our right answer is 3. Next, the terms marginal standing facility rate and net demand time liability, these terms are related with which section of economy? And it is clearly banking operation. Which of the following grant direct credit assistance to rural household? We know that RRBs, they grant loan to rural households. NABARD is an apex body for development of rural areas, but we should remember that NABARD do not give credit directly to rural household. They give fund to rural institution which are engaged in development of agriculture and rural areas. So NABARD will not be the answer. And the land development bank, yes, they also give long-term agriculture funds to farmers. So our answer is 1 and 3 only. Let's move to the next question. The national income of a country for a given period is equal to, what is the national income? They are asking national income. So normally we come to know that GDP or GNP is considered as the national income, gross national product or gross domestic product. What we know that gross national product is the better measurement of national income. So the question is total value of goods and services produced by the nationals. So clearly it is talking about GNP. After that, sum total of consumption and investment expenditure, no. Sum of personal income of all individuals, no. Next, money value of final goods and services produced. Yes, to some extent this is true, but here it is not clear whether it is talking about GDP or it is talking about GNP. Because it is not clear, because they have not mentioned geographical demarcation. So we will take the answer option A as the right answer, because it gives an idea about gross national product. Next question. A rise in general level of prices may be caused by that a general level of prices is increasing. Why? Option statement 1, an increase in the money supply. Obviously, when money supply is increased in the economy, it will lead to the inflation. Next, a decrease in the aggregate. So, option 1 is correct. Next, a decrease in the aggregate level of output. Output means if production is decreased, then obviously production, if the production is decreased, so the number of product available in the market also decrease. So the want or the demand of that product will increase and it will lead to inflation also. So statement 2 is also correct. Next, an increase in the effective demand. Obviously we just saw it, if the demand increases in economy, it will lead to price rise. So statement 3 is also correct. So our right answer is D, 1, 2 and 3. Next question. Currently base year of calculating GDP has been changed. What is the new base year? So we know that 2011-12 is the base year, current base year. Next question. Who is credited with the bringing the term invisible hand? We know that invisible hand term is related with capitalistic investment and capital market, capitalistic investment, that is the cap where the capital, the market forces decided which company will survive or which will not. And we know that it is the Adam Smith, who is the father of modern economics. He used this word, invisible hand. Intermediate goods are not included to calculate the final output, because yes, we know that if t-shirt is a final product, so cotton etc, thread etc, these are intermediate good. We know that intermediate goods are already included in the final goods, so intermediate goods are not included to calculate final output, because it will lead to the double counting. So our answer is C. This next question. Which of the following is the main motive of the government behind the introduction of goods and services tax? Obviously it will replace all indirect taxes, almost. It will increase government revenue and it will bring tax uniformity in the country, because all national of the India will have to pay a single tax, in indirect tax, and GST is an indirect tax, please remember this point. So GST will one, it is sometimes also referred as one nation one tax. So the right answer is all of the above. Thank you so much for watching the video, and if you like the video, please like, share and subscribe so that I can make more videos. If you like it, then I can understand that I will make more videos. Thank you so much for watching the video.